Hello there, welcome back. I'm Tristan, this is my workbench. Today I'm going to be looking at the Baofeng T1 volume modification. What you'll notice is when you open the squelch, the screw is far too loud. Like I said, when you open the squelch, the volume is far too loud. Even when you go to the lowest volume level, as you can see, it's set to only 1. But when I open the squelch, it's really very loud. So in this video I'm just going to show you how to open this and modify the circuit. It's very, very simple. All you need is one resistor and the value is 20k or 22k, or nearest to that as you can get. So inside the Baofeng T1 is the amplifier chip, the LN4890. In minus, the negative input terminal, differential minus, and 5, negative output terminal, differential minus. So here is the example circuit of the LN4890, which is the audio chip inside the Baofeng T1. And you'll notice there's actually a 20k resistor here between this in minus and VO1 to actually reduce the volume to the loudspeaker. What this is actually doing, if you're into electronics, is acting as a negative feedback to reduce the volume. So today what we're going to do is install this 20k resistor, or nearest to 20k as we can get, between the VO1 and the inverting input of this audio chip that's in the Baofeng T1. Okay, so we need to turn the radio off, turn it over, remove the back covers by taking off these two little screws here. There's a little clip here. Also remove the belt clip if you haven't done so already. Next, remove the battery. Carefully remove the power connector. Okay, well now see if we can open up this radio. So it looks like there's 4 screws there. Okay, remove those 4 screws. We need to try and get this back off. So we need to get something below it. So you can either use a credit card or a store card or whatever you want to call these, or a guitar plectrum, and just get in between this outer bit here and there. So you can start anywhere you like, wherever it feels slackest. Anyway, that feels quite good. So at this point I'll get my Screwfix card. And you see, it comes away rather nicely. So at this point we have the circuit board. And you notice here that this rubber piece falls out. So just put it carefully to one side. Make sure you put it back in later. So now we have the circuit board. The next thing we need to do is remove these 4 little screws here. Now keep these separate from the previous 4 little metal screws, because they are shorter than the other screws. These are the other screws. If you notice the length. Okay, so now we should be able to lift that out of the way and turn the whole thing over. So this, my friends, is the Baofeng's T1 circuit board, and here's the chip with the LN4890 which we're going to modify. Okay, so we saw on the data sheet that we could put in a 20k resistor. If you only got a 22k, that's really close. Or in my case, I've also got 15k resistors. The lower the value, the quieter the minimum volume will be. So today I'm going to install a 15k resistor. Alright, so I think the easiest way of doing it is to bend the leads of the resistor a bit like this. So we just want to lay it down, and then we're going to route it so that this lead on the left comes over the chip. So just cut that, and then on this side bend this round here, cut this lead round here, okay, starting to get there now. So we just need to give that a bit of a bend, like that. Bend it down a bit more with the tiny little screwdriver. So, are we happy with that? Yeah. It's not amazing, is it? Okay, the next bit is to lift the resistor out of the glue tack. Remove the glue tack. And the good thing about blue tack, you can use blue tack to remove more blue tack by doing that. And then finally, get some heat shrink tubing, stick it over the resistor. Okay, so I just heat shrink it, just so it doesn't come off. So we need to attach this back. So we're using the very small screws. Remember to put the aerial in. Make sure the speaker wire isn't trapped. Battery back in. What you find is that you can tuck the lead down there, then across. Like that. Here we are, the last two screws. So we test the monitor button now. Set on volume of 1. Only one again, which is a lot more civilised. I can actually speak while it's actually on. So there we have it. That's how to modify a Baofeng T1 using just one resistor to reduce the minimum volume. If you enjoyed that video, then please give me a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.